The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, where we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596, or you can check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody. So real quick, an update for Maui Strong. If you need to know about any resources or have any tips for that, all you got to do is go to teamlally.com, and right at the top of our front page, there's a link. It just says Maui Strong. Click on it. And what are they going to see there, Adrian?
There's going to be all sorts of resources available for people and nonprofits that have been vetted, as well as just different resources as well for if you are a victim of the Lahaina fires.
So real quick, we're going to go through the four things that we're recommending that people do. Number one, and these are not in order of importance, this is the order we're going in. Number one, if you're thinking about visiting Maui,
you should.
Go and
spend a lot of money there.
Spend a lot of money. Tip your servers. 80% of their economy is dependent on a visitor dollars. So go visit the island of Maui, Maui no Kauai. That translates for Maui is the best. Go there. Have fun. Don't be a busy, nosy, busybody and go to Lahaina.
Stay away from Lahaina.
Stay away from Lahaina, but go everywhere else on Maui and
spend
enjoy.
Your money. Support the local businesses.
Yeah. And this is coming from local people. I'm local. I have over probably 100-plus family that live over there. And they need you to visit. Whether they work in tourism directly or indirectly, it's all interconnected with the economic dollar that is spent there. So go visit. We hear that the planes are open. The beaches are open. There's not a lot of people because of this misperception that, like, the whole island burned down. It's just a small section. It's heartbreaking. It's terrible. But here's the deal. The people that lived in that area are probably staying with family that are in other areas that need to go to work and help their family that was in that area. So go visit Maui. Number two is make sure that you know, the number one resources that the nonprofits need is what?
Money.
Money, because everybody's sending out these lists on social media and at your workplace and at your gym, and they're getting all this stuff come in and it's not matching up to the needs. But if you give the organizations the money, they can buy what is needed in the moment because it's constantly changing.
And make sure that you're sending it out to legit vetted organizations.
Yes.
And again, you can go to our website and we've provided all resources that are legit.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, there's some people that are scammers and, you know, taking advantage. So,
and even the people that have good intentions, they're not really put, you know, they don't have the effective resources to handle it. Number three, if you're a victim, make sure you get registered with FEMA. It has been considered a national disaster. And for the vendors that are signed up with FEMA to help the people, that's how they identify you as somebody that needs the help. And one of the friends that we had on our show, they are one of the vendors that is helping find housing. If you're an agent on the island or a property owner, give us a call, because even if you have some family that are staying in the home already and you're doing it for free, give us a call because we can get you connected with these vendors that'll...
They'll pay for 12 months of rent or even up to 18 months.
Yeah.
And if you have a vacation rental that's empty or just a long-term rental... They will match you with a family in need, and they're going to pay the rents.
And if you're an agent over there, we've actually got the word just the other day from our friends running this housing thing. They'll pay you $500 finder fee if you can get a property owner once they're matched up and have the tenant in place. If you're the victim, here's how it works. They're going to sign the lease. They're going to pay the rent.
They're going to house. They're going to put all of the housing, like the furniture.
Get it all organized.
Ready to go.
Yeah. So that is it, housing is the best way to get everybody back on their feet, literally, figuratively, and financially. So please just go to our website, teamlally.com. It's right there at the top of the page. We've been dealing with nonprofits the entire real estate career. We know it's a big part of our business. So we make sure that we want to connect you and point you in the direction of people that are helping and not hurting.
That's right.
Maui strong. All right. So, speaking of someone that is Oahu strong in property management, who's that, Adrian?
That would be Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Hey, Duke.
Hello, guys. Wow, good information on that.
Yeah. So, yeah, and so, yeah, that's the best thing we can do for those people is let's get them into some housing, get everything up and running. Speaking of housing, because your company, your team, you guys are critical to housing here on Oahu.
What's your tip for this week?
It is the credit check. The credit score is not the final check.
Yeah.
So sometimes people have good credit scores, but they have no job.
Oh.
We just had a guy with 811 credit,
mm-hmm.
and he was between jobs by choice. He says that he was just looking for another job and looking for something that he can do remote to the mainland. And I said, well, you can reapply when you get a job. So he had no income, and he only had like $12,000 in savings. And the rent that he was going to try and apply for was $3,500.
Oh, yeah, that would be gone pretty quickly. Like maybe like a couple months, you know.
It just isn't a lot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, and he had a good credit score, didn't have a job. And then, you know, sometimes we have people with good credit scores, they have a job, but they don't make enough income.
Yeah.
So when that happens, I look at their bank accounts and see how much savings they got in there. And they most of the time, they have over $10,000 in savings, which tells me that they run their life pretty well.
Yeah.
So you'd make like a judgment call. Like you're looking at additional pieces of information, not just like this is your pay stub.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Correct. But you got to know that we have a vested interest in it, because if I judge wrong and we have to evict them at some point, then they're probably going to be under the eviction guarantee.
And which is what?
We have to pay for. We have to pay for the eviction. Right. So the eviction guarantee states that if we put somebody in that we have to evict, that we'll pay the legal costs to get them out.
Wow.
Of course, we never want that.
Yeah.
Yeah. We never want that, because you'll already be 2 months behind in rent.
Yeah.
And evictions right now are taking 3 months.
Yeah. Well, one of the things we heard, the governor passed a moratorium on the evictions for that area in Lahaina and stuff like that. And foreclosures. So I think 90 days or something like that. But everybody's willing to work with the people as long as you stay in communication.
Yeah, yeah. They all have a vested interest on that island. But, you know, like the amount of jobs lost in Lahaina is just unbelievable.
Yeah.
So that was such a big tourist area.
Yeah. And
so it's a bummer.
Yeah. So with the you know, what's happening with the rental rates? They going up? They stabilizing? What are you seeing?
Values in Hawaii, especially on the west side, are still going up.
Yeah.
It just shocks me when I see something on the west side, single family home, that's under $1 million.
Yeah.
But there still are.
Yeah.
You know, we see houses that are coming in for rent, 3-bedroom, 2.5-bath, and it's not a townhouse, it's a single family home for like $875.
Wow.
We actually have one on the west of a beach, one that's listed for $899, 3 bedrooms, 2.5-bath.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
no
rare,
maintenance. Well, very low maintenance fee too.
Yeah.
So
what's funny is now all that whole Pili stuff is starting to come in.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of military bought that with no money down, and you know they have monthly payments upward of $4,700.
Wow.
So it's hard. It's hard to rent out something and make money when you have a mortgage of $4,700 and have a $109 maintenance fee.
Yeah.
So that's almost $5,000.
Yeah.
So after, you know, after they net out, they're probably going to net loss because they have GE tax to pay. They have a 10% property management fee.
Yeah.
Yep. So they got all these fees to pay.
Yeah.
So, Duke, I love how you're bringing this up because, you know, it sounds like when, you know, especially our military members are getting ready to leave, you're running the numbers for them and giving them a realistic outlook of what that's going to look like if they choose to rent their home out.
And what kind of reserves
they're going to need.
Yeah.
And it's really tough to bring them the news, you know, after we assess their house.
Yeah.
And that they're going to be negative over $1,000 a month and going to a place where the BAH is lower. I don't know how you can make that happen.
Yeah.
So, you know, a lot of times they tell us, oh, we're dual military and we're planning to come back to Hawaii, so we want to keep our house here.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good reason.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, in a three-year deployment somewhere else, like in Louisiana or Colorado or somewhere else, the BH is really low.
And no COLA, most likely, because the Hawaii is one of the places that has the COLA, cost of living adjustment.
Yeah. So. It's really shocking and alarming when I have to give that news. And a lot of times I tell them, I advise you to sell.
Yeah.
And, you know, and same thing for us. When we're sitting down with clients and it looks like that they would have some positive cash flow, we advise them to at least sit down with Duke and his team and run those numbers and, you know, see what that looks like to hold on to the property.
Well, it says something about Duke. Duke, you're more focused on their goals and priorities, not just trying to sign up another PM.
Exactly.
Painful. It's painful when you have to tell an owner that they're going to be over $1,000 negative each month. Ooh. And that's with nothing going wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, you know, one washer blowout or, you know, maybe a water heater.
Or a vacancy for like a month or two. Vacancy, like it's just like it's like would be like this whole domino effect.
Yeah.
So.
And, you know, a lot of times the people are asking us if it's a good thing, if their place would rent for more if they had PV.
Yeah.
And the answer is yes and no. Mm. But the PV cost is so expensive right now. I mean, you're talking about $30,000. And the finance rate on that is like 7 or 6%. So, you know, that's a $200, $250 payment interest only.
Wow. Yeah, so all those numbers got to crunch.
Yep, it's got to make sense.
Yeah. Well, you know, give us a call if you have any questions, and we'll give them a free estimate.
Thank you. Thank you, Duke.
Correct.
Thank you,
Duke. You're welcome. Thank you.
Okay. Hey, agents out there, if you're sitting, you can do the same thing we're doing. Come from contribution and give your clients a rental analysis. Call Duke. He'll do a rental analysis for you, and you'll come off like a consultant versus a salesperson.
Yep. So Duke and his team, you can find him on teamlally.com under the resource tab and experts we trust.
So another expert we trust is someone that's going to help you in that moment of truth and maybe help you do some reviews of your life situation to see about that moment of truth. He is the Mr. Miyagi of insurance, and he's going to talk to you today about wax on and wax off.
That would be Bradley Maruyama of AllState Insurance.
Hey, Bradley, what you got for us this week?
Okay, so my tip of the week this week will be mainly for tenant-occupied or investment homes.
Yes.
And specific coverage is called rent loss. So, you know, we've had some tragedies, but it also made me think about all these condo owners and homes that are rented out.
Uh-huh.
And if you don't have enough rent loss insurance, if the home is not occupied because of a fire or hurricane, can you sustain not having that rent for 12 months, 24 months, and what does that look like? So like you just recently said 10 seconds ago, have you reviewed your policy? Do you know how much rent loss you're getting?
And if you even have it.
In the event of a fire or hurricane. And do you even have it? Because I'll tell you, you know, at closing, most people... For hurricane insurance here on Oahu, they'll take the bare minimum with no rent loss insurance on there. So, and even more so, condos or HO6 policies don't require hurricane insurance.
Yeah.
And so a lot of people don't realize that the AOL doesn't give you rent loss if your townhouse is burnt down to the ground or if there's a hurricane that comes through and it's demolished down to the bare soil.
Yeah.
So, Bradley, with the rent loss insurance, like how much extra per year or even like per month would it be to add this like little rider onto your policy?
Yeah, so maybe if you're looking for like 50,000 in coverage, you may be looking at maybe $75 per year.
Wow. Oh, man.
And
that's about the same price as free refill extra large popcorn at the movie theater.
So I wanted to share a call that we had gotten earlier this week. This lady probably did not have rent loss insurance, but you know, unfortunately, she had a bunch of vacation rentals in Lahaina. It was like
that was her only income.
That was she, elderly lady. It was her only income, and you know, $2 million mortgage, and she was using the income to pay the mortgage. So
plus her own bills.
Yeah. So, you know, having this rent loss insurance would have helped, I think, with, you know, the stress of now, like, okay, how am I going to pay this mortgage when I don't have rental income?
Yeah. So that's a real life story there for this. And it's not that much money. And people should really think about that. I remember on the freeway about IAI area, I saw a condo and it was like all burned out. Mm-hmm. I swear I must have seen that thing for like a year and a half. And I finally just drove by recently. I saw like the whole building's been repainted and everything. But this is a top floor condo. People who know on the freeway, Mauka side of the freeway heading in towards IAI, you can see it every day. It was like completely burned. And that took a long time for them to fix that and get it up to speed and probably put somebody back in there.
And hopefully they had rent loss insurance.
Hopefully. Because that took...
Hopefully they had Bradley as their...
I would guess that was a year and a half.
As their insurance agent, and he advised them that this maybe would be 2 years. Smartest. Yeah.
Okay, Bradley, thank you so much.
Thanks, Bradley.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, you want to get hold of Bradley? How can we do that, Adrian?
Go to our website, teamlally.com, and under the resource tab and experts we trust, you can find Bradley and you can find a video that we did with Bradley. Yeah. He's an awesome guy. Give him a call.
And something that everybody is talking about all across the United States, everywhere, maybe in the world, mortgage interest rates, and to help help us navigate and bring us some clarity to that discussion, who do we have, Adrian?
That would be Jodie Tonga, the mortgage genius.
Hey, Jodie.
Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Hi, guys.
Hello. What you got for us?
So I'll give an update on mortgage rates.
Yes.
About 3 weeks ago, we had reached all-time highs. And not all-time highs, but all-time highs in the past, like, two decades. And as of today, we have seen the rates improve. So yesterday and today, they have come down. So we are no longer at all-time highs. And the reason is because there have been some adjustments to the GDP reports from the second quarter. So pretty much what happens economically is that data continues to come in. There's, you know, estimations, and then it gets a little bit more accurate and then a little bit more accurate. And all of these quarterly reports continue to get tweaked until it's, you know, the most accurate that it can be. And so on number one, there were changes to the second quarter GDP, which were worse than anticipated. And so that made a small improvement on interest rates. And then coupled by today, there was some job reports that came out, which is just unemployment data, basically. And that was a little worse than expected. And then now the big question is what's going to happen on Friday. So there's what we call the big jobs report, which comes out on Friday. And that could either erase these mortgage interest rate improvements if that jobs report comes in where unemployment is on pace with what everyone expects, what the market expects, then that could easily wipe out these interest rate improvements. But if it's worse, then it's very likely that rates will actually get better.
Yeah.
So Jodie, when you say that they've improved, are they under, have they come in under 7, or are they still in that low 7?
Yeah, for a broker. So like your local broker, you know, mortgage brokers are going to be conventionally probably just under 7, so like 6.875. And then VA is probably around 6.375, 6.5.
Yeah.
Well, that's a pretty decent improvement and positive news.
It is.
Yeah. So we see things that they've kind of started to slow down as those interest rates have been creeping up. And we're excited to see maybe some of those buyers that were waiting for the rates to start dropping to come back out of the woodworks.
Well, it's like the federal chair was in Jerome Powell. He's keeping an eye on inflation. And he's what he says is pretty, as a pretty big effect in the marketplace. They said that his speech last year, I guess they all come together in Jackson Hole, Wyoming, and it's the Federal Reserve Conference. And then when he spoke last year, the Dow dropped, I mean, not the Dow, but the stock market dropped 1,000 points. So it's good that he is optimistic. He says they're happy with the results of what's happening with inflation, but they're still keeping an eye on it.
Right. Yeah. That's exactly. So he still has his hedge where, I'm not going to say we're done.
Yes.
Increasing rates, but I am going to say that finally, only now are we seeing some of the slowdown that like they need to see, right? In order for inflation to continue coming down.
Mm-hmm. That's a good thing because we don't want to, you know, there's countries like Argentina where it's like $50,000 for a loaf of bread. You know, because they didn't have these type of, you know, you've seen it. If you just look around the world, you see all these kind of different kind of inflation when it runs away in other countries. We heard it's a good time to visit Japan.
Yeah.
It's like $1.50 to our dollar.
Right.
Yeah. So anyway, Jody, as far as trending for strategies, what is it? And are we still seeing it? The 2-1 buy downs, 3-1 buy downs?
I mean, we have one that we just got accepted this week. So, yes, we're still seeing it.
Yeah.
We just learned about a really cool program where, you know how the 2-1 buy down requires that the seller be the one, the contributor, in order to allow the buyer to participate in the program.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So there's a new product that I found, which is very exciting, which it's more of like a indirectly let the buyer pay for it.
Ooh, nice. So do tell.
Let's
do
say
tell.
The seller's not, the seller's not willing to play ball.
Yeah.
But the buyer's like, I really want the 1% lower. Like, you know, so whatever you're going to, let's say your normal rate that you are going to get locked in at was 6.875.
Uh-huh.
Now we have a product that's going to be able to give them a 5.875.
For at least a year. And so then
for 1 year.
And then they get bumped up unless they refinance because the rates are so much better.
Yeah.
Right. And that's what we've kind of been asking for.
Mm-hmm.
Because in our market, sellers aren't necessarily rolling over to necessarily pay for that, you know?
Yeah.
It's not like just
automatic, let's do it.
To a halt.
Yeah.
Right.
Or the other thing, Jody, is that, you know, sometimes sellers are willing to pay for some of it, but not all of it. Will that product allow for like a little bit from the buyer and a little bit from the seller?
Some sharing?
Yeah.
Yes, it will.
Okay, good.
And so it's the first I've heard of it. It's extremely exciting. And I haven't done one yet. You know, you know how we are about that. We don't really we have to make everyone know and understand that this is not necessarily a product that we have vetted yet.
Yes.
But I just did the certification and the webinar where we learn what it means and what are the requirements and how can we offer it and stuff like that. So that's definitely something that's going to be part of our tool belt.
Yeah. You know what? I want to talk about, you said it on one of our huddles, because we have Jodie on our huddles to talk to our team, keep them in the know. Is that you have a client, you're in escrow, you got them an interest rate, and they call you flipping out going, I thought I could, whatever the document you talked about, it looks like here I could have got this instead of that.
Oh, right, right.
And then, it's like Paul Harvey, rest his soul, he's dead. But he had a show and he would say, and now you know the rest of the story. So tell us the rest of the story when people see the interest rate you got them and then they see a document that you have to give them and it says, I could have got this. What's the rest of the story?
Right. So that's the anti-steering disclosure form.
Yes.
Which is basically saying that we have the ability to show you and offer you lower and higher interest rates than you may have locked in at.
Yeah.
And the whole cost benefit is that the lower the interest rate, the more you're going to have to dish out of pocket. And we had spent a good amount of time on why she went with the rate that she went with.
Yes, and she forgot.
And it's just that when she saw this form and she was like, wait, 5.875, like, I want that,
yeah.
You know? And I was like, I said, okay, remember when we talked, when we did the math and I did the difference between the two monthly payments and then we multiplied it by 12.
Yes.
And then we compared that to your points, which is the additional amount that you're going to have to pay. She was like, oh yeah, I remember that. I said, okay, so this is even taking it one step further, because now instead of only paying 1 point, we're talking about paying like 3 points. Like, yeah. And you know, then she was like, oh, I don't want to do that, you know, because we talked about it, because there's such a high probability that she's going to be refinancing in the future. And so now you're not going to be able to earn back or recuperate the amount of money that you just dished out just to be able to say, well, look at me, I got a 5.875.
Yeah. I think, but here's the cautionary tale to you borrowers out there before you go, squirrel, talk to Jodie so she can talk you off the ledge.
So she can advise you and come up with the appropriate strategy based on your goals and your situation.
And remind you.
Because she knows the numbers and, you know, she's going to break it down in a very simple way that's easy to understand.
And Jodie, you find this too, right? A transaction doesn't take like 2 days. It's not like you go to the store, buy a pack, give them the money, give them the pack of gum, and then you got the gum.
Mm-mm.
It takes a while. Right. And there's a lot of information we're covering with people over that timeline of 30 to 45 to 60 days, and they're going to forget.
That's right.
So don't be like, oh, just call Jodie.
Just give her a call.
Call her again.
Thank you, Jodie.
Thanks, Jodie.
Excellent info, as always.
Thank you. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
So that's Jodie Tonga of Pacific Rim Mortgage. You can find her on the resource tab on our website under Experts We Trust.
Hey, if you're a realtor out there and you're like, hey, who should I put onto my team? Go no further. Go to our Experts We Trust tab. We vetted them out, and they are a critical key to our success, and they can be the key to your success. So give them a call. Book on them an appointment. Jodie has, you know, brought a lot of our deals from the brink of destruction to a rebirth and keep going and moving forward and close. So give her a call. Go book an appointment. Go visit her office. Okay. Tell her you heard about her on the Team Lally show.
So next up, before we take our break, we have a Jake with Skyta Construction Roofing and Solar with his tip of the week.
Hey, Jake, what you got for us?
Well, hey, guys.
Yes.
Tip of the week is, if you guys got roofs that are leaking or got them shingles pulling off after the last windstorm, it's time to give us a call. I just, you might hear some traffic going by because I just got off a rooftop and adjuster came out, looked at the house. The homeowner made a claim because the shingles were peeled up a little bit.
Uh-huh.
And she wanted to get the roof covered. And so we came out with the insurance company, showed them the damage. And then they said, hey, we've done a lot of claims with you guys at Skyta. We really like you. Whatever you put forward to us to cover, we're going to cover, which of course they needed a brand new roof, $25,000. We got the homeowner covered. They even have panels on the roof where that's covered as well. Can get the old panels taken down and then reinstalled after. So anyway, if you're sitting there and you're like, ah, I think I got some damage on my roof, we can have one of our guys come out, check it, make sure you check it, and don't repair it yourself, or else insurance doesn't tend to pay
and you
once
guys,
it's already repaired.
And you guys speak a language that hardly anybody speaks. It's a rare language. It's called insurance language.
Insurance adjuster language.
Insurance adjuster language.
It is.
I think there's a small island off of Papua New Guinea that the natives still speak it there. And then at all the insurance companies. Those are the only locations. But you're excellent at speaking insurance agent adjuster. So good job on that.
And it also, it sounds like, you know, if you are a Skyta customer and you've got their panels on your roof and you think that there might be some challenges that, you know, you guys are, you know, like, oh, your panels are installed. See ya. It's like you're always there.
Yeah.
So, for example, you guys installed the panels on my roof. And if I notice there's some kind of damage, I know Jake is going to be there to help
checking
me with this insurance claim.
So what's cool is you guys got the roofing, you got the solar panels, you got the charging stations, you got
the AC.
AC,
you can, central. You can bundle it. You can bundle it in together.
You can bundle it. And Jake, you guys are you're like a virus against a leaky roof because you go and check the shingles. shingles. So it's like if you're 55 and older, you should get the shingles virus vaccination.
Yes, the vaccine.
But you're like for those old roofs, you're like a shingles vaccination for a leaky roof.
That's exactly right. And I wanted to give a quick shout out. I'm actually in Lahaina out in Maui right now.
Oh, yeah. What you doing?
We've had bunch of our customers because we're on Big Island, Maui, and Oahu.
Yes.
And we have bunch of our customers in North Lahaina and then in Kula as well, Kihei. And so there's been a bunch of windstorms and of course the fire.
Yeah.
And we couldn't get a hold of any of our customers because there's no internet and no cell phone coverage for some time. So anyway, we've checked in with all of our customers up there and we're replacing roofs up there. So if you guys got family and you're listening right now and many of the roofing companies here in Maui are busy for over a year.
Whoa.
As we've called all the top ones. So we've got the big team out here and we're helping Lahaina and the Lahaina area.
Oh, right on.
Get all this stuff covered with insurance. So if you guys got family out there and you're listening right now and you're like, oh, my family needs to have their house checked on or need to see about the roof, we're happy to come out and check it for them. And that's no cost to them. It's what we're doing to help out there.
Yeah, and those, you need that for the insurance, for this and that. And so it's good to get you. You know, the good news is that I know some of these people are coming in from the mainland and they want to be helpful, but the best thing that we can do for our local economy is use local construction local people, local vendors. And Skyta, I know, is locally owned right here on Oahu, and you guys work on all the islands. So it's important that we do this, you know, when we come back from all of this, is that we have those dollars keep pumping back into our own economy. So good job on that.
Yeah. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Jake, for all you do. That's right.
Okay. All righty. Thanks, Jake.
Keep
helping those people.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay. So Jake is also, he's on the resource tab and Experts We Trust, along with Skyta Construction Roofing and Solar.
Yeah,
check them out.
If you're a realtor at any island, give Jake a call to see what he can do for your clients. You know, one of the things we do is we always... it's always good to have that roofing person because a lot of times in the home inspection or buying a home, you know, that can be a costly thing that you want to be aware of, either selling or buying, that the roof is not going to be leaking shortly thereafter your closing.
So before we take a break, I want to just share like a brief bullet point overview of a recent success story.
Go ahead.
It was, her name was Misty, and she hired Laura and Team Lally in 2020 to help find a new home in Hawaii. And she was stationed overseas due to pandemic restrictions and relied on our team for detailed showings and to be on site for inspections. You want to chime in?
No, keep going.
No. Okay. In 2023, she was alerted she would be reassigned to the mainland, but had no time frame as to when her orders would arrive.
Yeah, all today. After Laura advised Misty on her options, they decided to capitalize on the summer influx of buyers and list the house for sale.
So part of the strategy included needing a flexible timeline to close since our seller needed her orders before she could close.
When we sat down to analyze the pricing strategy, we were faced with her next door neighbor's homes as a comparable sale, which home buyers and appraisers look at to determine value. Now listen to this. The neighboring house is the exact same, built at the same time as her house, and closed for take a note of this number. Neighbor's house, closed, same house, identical. People were like coming to open houses and they were confused which house to go because they looked the same.
Yeah, exactly.
$757,000. And what did Laura and our team do for Misty?
Yeah, so Misty was hoping to get closer to $800,000. So we were confident given the condition of Misty's home and that it could hold a higher market value. So we came up with a strategy that procured 5 qualified offers.
We were unable to educate the appraiser.
We were able yes.
to educate the appraiser on all the updates throughout the home, and the home appraised for offer price.
So Misty closed on her home, earning $795,000, almost $40,000 more than her neighbor's house, which just had closed, I believe it was like 60 days earlier.
Yeah.
With the flexible timeline she needed, she even got additional time in the house after closing to allow for her movers to finish up.
She's enjoying her last couple of days on island before starting her new chapter in Texas, and will be attending the next F45 class with Laura.
Yay.
Yay. Misty's like, I didn't know that. But yeah, we get sweaty with our clients. You know, we invite you to workouts.
All right. So we are going to take a break, but stay with us. When we come back, we're going to be talking to Shaun Henna of Ultra Lock and Key LLC. Yeah. We're going to talk about the services that they provide and tips on how to avoid lockout incidents.
Yes. Stay with us.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Antilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it. Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Hello, Hawaii. It's Colin Cowherd. Things may have changed in the sports world, but the games must go on. Look, I invest in real estate all over America, and right now with the ultra-low interest rates everywhere, if you're serious about selling your home, you need to talk to my friends Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally, real estate group of Keller Williams Honolulu. Team Lally's incredible marketing with 3D tours and its huge database of buyers has continued to sell homes quickly with multiple offers over the asking price. Adrian and Attilio continue to spend tens of thousands per month on marketing to attract hundreds of buyers every month using a unique app that communicates daily with over 3 million luxury home buyers around the United States. Adrian and Antilio guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it themselves. Give Adrian and Antilio a call at 799-9596 or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And start packing.
If you're looking for an outstanding insurance agent that will personally help you during the moment of truth, we recommend Bradley Maruyama with Allstate Insurance.
So, Attilio, what do you mean by the moment of truth?
Well, the best insurance is the insurance you never have to use. But we know that's not how life works. So when life happens, you can count on Bradley and his team to exceed your expectations for your insurance needs.
Keep in mind that when buying a home, the cost of home insurance should be taken into consideration. I trust Bradley with my own personal home, so you should give him a call. Call Bradley with Allstate Insurance at 591-801.
Tired of waiting 2 to 3 months to finalize your home loan or refinance? Jodie Tonga and her team at Pacific Rim Mortgage have a turn time of 30 days or less by processing your loans locally.
Take advantage of today's low interest rates by calling our good friend Jodie Tonga of Pacific Rim Mortgage. Her personal cell is 488-5510. That's 488-5510.
Hey, Adrian, guess what?
What, Attilio?
Jodie has a huge secret.
Oh, yeah? What is it?
I can tell you.
Yes, you can.
Okay, here it is. Jodie has a free home buying guide that reveals insider tips others may not want you to know.
Wow, how do I get this free home buying guide?
Easy. Just go to her website, pacificrim.com. That's PAC or PACRIMMTG.com.
I see the free home buyer guide has valuable information that can help me avoid mistakes and could cost me tens of thousands of dollars over the lifetime of my loan.
Yes. So check out their site. That's pacificrim.com or give her a call at 488-5510. That's 488-5510. What's the website?
It's PAC, RIM, R-I-M, Mortgage, MTG.com. Hawaii, NMLS ID 1032554.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm still Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Our guest today is the owner of Ultra Lock and Key LLC. He grew up in Kahaluu, moved to Honolulu during middle school, and is currently based here. He started out as an apprentice locksmith in 2011 after 6 years of mentorship by Richard Berrios Sr. and Richard Jr. from Affordable Locksmith and Son. He launched Ultra Lock and Key. Please welcome our guest, Shaun Henna. He is the Karate Kid of locksmithing.
And I just also want to add to that a big shout out to our mechanic, Usman, which is
who referred us to him,
which is how we came into contact with Shaun.
And Usman
Shaun,
in Waipahoo.
And Shaun has helped us out several times.
So yes. Good job, Shaun. Yep. So, Shaun, let's get to it because, you know, when I say Karate Kid of the locksmith is because it sounds like you worked with two people that were like Mr. Miyagi. They're like, unlock this car.
It was.
Lock the car. Unlock the car. Lock the car.
Wax on, wax
off. Yeah. And then finally you're like, did they bring you into a room and then tell you that once you snatch the pebble from my hand, you will be graduated to full-on locksmith? No, that was karate.
Like
that was
that.
The movie Kung Fu.
I don't think he was snatching that the pebble. I think he was snatching the car key, the car fob. The car fob.
Yeah. So let's talk about your business. Couple exciting things. You know, nothing becomes top of mind more so when it happens to you. So I want to talk about the fact that I had a vehicle on Turo, and then I get the client call, text me. They're like, hey, we was at Walmart. And we dropped the fob that starts your vehicle at Walmart, and it exploded into a million pieces. And I'm like, huh? Because I've dropped the thing all the time. But anyway, it was a freak accident. And they're like, we kind of put it together, and we got the car open and started, but we need a new fob. So I took a new fob over there. And then this was like, I think they hadn't gone anywhere for a couple of days because they were just hanging out at Kohlina. But then I get a frantic calls and text messages. They're trying to leave to go to the airport to catch their flight, and the second fob I gave them doesn't work.
Why? Why didn't the second fob work, Attilio?
Dead battery. And
then what did Shaun do to save the day?
Shaun, I came to see Shaun, and he was like in that movie Sixth Sense. He's like, I see dead fobs. And now you have a solution for that. So let's walk people through that because
he's got a solution for both of those situations.
For both of those situations, because here's the deal. After all the dust settled, I went to the Servco dealership. Sorry, Servco. It was $500 to replace this fob. And I'm like, what? You giving me one that's gold plated and does my kids' homework? What the heck? $500 for a fob. So, Shaun, let's talk about, well, first of all, your inventory of the cases for these fobs, because we had you on a video and I looked behind you and I thought it was like a wall of like maybe you had a yo-yo collection or maybe these were Pokemon cards, but these are cases for the fobs. How many do you think you have in your inventory?
Yes, the Great Wall. It's Great Wall of Fobs.
Yeah.
That I have like 28,000 pieces listed.
Oh, wow.
It's kind of it's pretty huge, man.
Yeah. So you don't have to go to, you're like the Amazon of key fobs for Oahu.
And the other thing that's really great about Shaun is that he's mobile. So you can go to him or he will come to you, depending on, you know.
Yeah, because I think there's a conspiracy with fobs. They're like, you know what? When they leave the house, we're going to let them start the car one more time. And when they go clubbing and it's 3 a.m. and they're the DD, we're not going to let the car start when you're downtown and in the middle of the night. And so, okay, dead fob, you know, because more and more of these cars are like how they start is with the button. They push the button. And so what's your first recommendation at that point? Because you gave me a great tip that saves the trip charge. And then Shaun, you know, I mean, you're going to have Shaun show up. He's going to be there, but he's going to be all like sleepy and stuff because it's like middle of the night. He can come. He's like Batman of the locksmith. But what did you what do you recommend or what people don't mostly know about with the fob when it's dead?
You can emergency start the car.
Yeah.
You know, if you have to, there's an insert blade inside of it. It's hidden. You can't normally see it.
Yeah.
But it's usually where the key ring is attached to. Uh-huh. You can pull it out, you know, and get in the car, because if the battery dies in the fob, your car is not going to open. You know, you're going to get stuck outside. So you're going to look at the handle first. If you see the lock cylinder,
then you get your insert blade, you pull it out, you stick it in and turn it to unlock, you open the door. But if you don't see the lock cylinder, you know, there's always a lock cylinder, like a backup cylinder to get in the car. So it's either going to be behind your handle or it's going to be modular. So you're going to go under the handle and it should be a little hole. You just poke it with the blade and pop the cap off. And then you'll see the lock cylinder. You can get in the car, touch the fob to the start button most times. But if not, you know, some cars have learning pockets or learning spots in it. And this is in the dealer, the manual that comes with the car.
Yeah.
Or you can look online, you know, and they'll always have an emergency slot or learning pocket.
Yeah. And so, again, the tip there is people, like, you know what the worst time to do a fire drill is? When the whole house is on fire. You do it beforehand so you're not all trying to figure it out at 3 in the morning in one parking garage in Waikiki. Is actually do it now at home with all the light and not three shots of tequila in you, and figure out how to remove the blade, how to insert it in the lock so you can manually open your fancy car, and then that emergency start. And I'll tell you, when I did the emergency start on my Lexus, it worked.
And then also have that that second key.
Yeah, so the second fob.
So I'm guilty, like both of my cars, I only have one fob. So I'm going to come see you, Shaun, so you can help me with that. But if any of our any of our listeners also are guilty with only having one key or one fob, I would say give Shaun a call. Go visit with him. He'll help you out because
Adrian, she's going to be like moonlight walk at Makapu, and then you're not going to be able to start her car. And then she can call me and I'll be like, oh, call Shaun. And then I'm going to hang up.
So Shaun's number, you can call him at 675-1522, 675-1522, and super responsive. He'll come to you. You can go to him. Yeah, but have that second fob if you only have the one.
Well, so it's important to, it's worth it probably to take your second fob. You know, so tell him about the thing that too that you taught me about the batteries that you buy at Long's. Sorry, Long's, you got batteries that's sitting on your shelf. It's like we're doing a show where...
It's only at Long's or anywhere?
Anywhere, like all these places, Walmart. So we're doing a show where we're repelling sponsors and telling them that this stuff doesn't work. But tell them about the little quarter-sized battery that goes in these remotes. Yeah. What do they need to know?
So at the big box stores, you know, there's not a lot of people buy the batteries, so they sit on the shelf. Usually for a long time.
Yeah.
You might get lucky, though, and then they put a new stock out. You know, batteries are fresh.
Yeah.
A lot of times they'll sit there, and then they'll just get old, you know, and they lose the voltage. And then, you know, you pop open the brand-new battery casing and put it in your fob. And it still don't work, so you think the fob's dead.
Yep.
You know, so it's always good to, maybe where you could bring it to me, and then I could check the battery. You know, I could make sure it's 3 volts or at least able to send out a voltage. And then if it is, it's probably your key fob dead.
Yeah.
But if not, and your battery voltage is low, I stock a lot of batteries. Like I pretty much have like every battery for all the fobs that's on the road. And I can replace it. And then you won't need to get a new fob.
Yeah. And Shaun does this crazy thing. He pays attention to the expiration dates on the batteries. Yeah.
So Attilio mentioned like a price that was quoted from the dealership. On average, Shaun, like how much money are you saving your customers from, like with your expertise and being able to help?
Yeah, anywhere from about $200 to $300.
Wow,
yeah.
That's a big savings.
And sometimes more, yeah.
Yeah, no, Shaun saved me about that much money. And it was, you know, when you go to a dealership, it's like going to the emergency room at a hospital. It's like a 12-hour ordeal. And you go to the dealership, the only reason you got the guy that got the nice waiting room and the coffee is because you're going to be there
forever
till you start collecting Social Security, because you're just there forever.
But not with Shaun.
Not with Shaun. I was like there like 15 minutes.
Yeah, he's quick.
And let me describe to you, Sean's not like, okay, boom, here you go. No, he's like, put the new battery, do the volt check of the battery, put it in the thing, and then you got to go hook up this computer to the thing and program the remote And then you tested all the features of the remote. So I'm not out at Kaena Point going, what the hell, Sean, this thing don't, you know, but so very thorough.
So we have about 5 minutes left in our show. And I want to make sure that we touch on this because, Sean, you're going to be launching a new company in 2024. Yeah. Can you share with us and our listeners a little bit about what you have in the near future?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's going to be called Artlu Car Keys.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going to focus on spare keys, and we're going to do a mobile service. So it's going to be by appointment, and we're not going to have a travel fee.
Yeah.
You know, just as long as it's on schedule and it's on the same route.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we'll come to you to the house or to your workplace.
You're like Merry Maids for the second key.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I know the house in Eva Beach you'd be going to do two of them already, Adrian. Is it like the kids be like, Mom, I dropped the remote in the ocean. Okay, bye. No. Well, go ahead, Sean.
That's exactly what happens.
Yeah.
But no, yeah, so it'll just be convenient because nowadays, you know, everybody wants convenience. They're so busy. You know, they don't want to drive nowhere. So we're just going to plan to, you know, come straight direct to you, make the spare key, fraction of the dealer price, and a lot of our keys, they're original, like genuine parts. We also have aftermarket, but I don't recommend aftermarket.
Yes,
you know, because it's Chinese parts, and well, most times Chinese, and it doesn't last long. You know, it works in the beginning, but over time it doesn't hold up as well as a genuine part. Yeah,
especially when you have a luxury vehicle or you're you know, whatever, your vehicle is important. You want to, I think safety is above price consciousness. And you know, the yellow Pokemon fob, just it's not going to last that long. You got to get the factory one.
Yeah, because if you think about it, you're going to spend, let's say, maybe $200 to $225 for aftermarket fob, right?
Yeah.
You could have got the genuine one for $300, maybe $350. Yeah, it's like maybe a $75, $100 difference. Yeah. But it's an investment, you know, because you don't want to get stranded 1 year later.
Yeah.
Stuck in a parking lot. And then you're going to have to pay another, you know, $350 for somebody to come out there and rescue you.
Yep.
So you should have just got the better part. You know, and that's what we're going to offer and kind of educate the customers about it. Because everybody, they don't, you know, they don't know about it and just think, yeah, if it works, it works. You know, but that's not the case. This is how long it's going to last for.
It's not all created equal.
Yeah. So people start getting on the list.
Exactly.
To do some preventive maintenance of not getting stuck somewhere in a parking garage in Waikiki or Kaena Point, I would highly recommend you call Sean. He's going to put you on the schedule.
675-1522, and it's Ultra Lock and Key. Sean, is there a good website that they can go to for your business?
Not yet.
Not yet. We'll just give them a little
right now, just the Yelp. The Yelp is the best, and then the website, it is under construction. We're going to make it all spiffy, nice, artistic,
We'll look at them on Yelp with all the great reviews. Give them a call.
Get on the schedule. Yep.
Get on the
schedule. He's like Santa Claus. He's going to come visit you if you're on the nice list, and not visit you if you're on the naughty list. You know what? He's going to visit you on the naughty list, but going to be like 3 in the morning at one parking garage in Waikiki and going to cost you more money.
That's right.
All right.
Thank you, Sean.
Thank you, Sean.
For being our guest.
You're welcome, guys. Thank you for having me.
Yes, we're going to have you on next year to give us an update on that nice list for replacing people's fobs. Thank you so much.
Okay, thanks for listening, and you're welcome. You to our sponsors.
Jerody and Derek of Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley.
Thanks, Sean.
Bradley with Allstate Insurance.
Kenji with Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke with Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle with Impact Wealth Solutions.
And Robinson with Fine Line Paintworks.
Chastity with American Floor and Home.
Jake with Skyta Construction Roofing and Solar.
Ryan of Zero Res Hawaii.
Amphi with Estate Planning Group.
And Jeff with the Loan Depot.
If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Yee-hoo.
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price and our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.